the founder of Android, Andy Rubin, has unveiled his new Android smartphone. Dubbed the Essential Phone PH1, the handset features a 5.71-inch, 2560x1312 edge-to-edge display. It also boasts Qualcomm's high-end Snapdragon 835 processor and what Rubin claims is one of the world's best phone cameras. The phone is made out of titanium, instead of aluminium, to help it survive accidental drops. It also features a ceramic back. It is modular and can be fitted with a 360-degree camera accessory. This clips to the rear of the phone, weighs 35 grams and includes a dual 12-megapixel fisheye sensors that can capture 4K 360 video at 30 fps. The back has a 13-megapixel dual camera system designed for low-light photography. The front camera of the Essential smartphone is a 8MP unit with a 16:9 aspect ratio. It comes with a magnetic connector, 128GB of internal storage, a 3040mAh battery, a USB Type-C port and a fingerprint sensor. The screen will protect it with Corning's Gorilla Glass 5 and will boast a 19:10 aspect ratio at 500 nits brightness. Average LCD displays produce between 200 to 300 nits. There is no traditional 3.5mm headphone jack, but The Verge claims it may ship with a headphone dongle in the box. The handset measures 5.6-inch, 141.5mm, tall, 2.8 inches, 71.1mm, across and 0.3 inches, 7.8mm, thick. It will weigh less than 6.5 ounces, 185 grams. Essential is launching the phone in the US to begin with, and it will be rolled out globally in the near future. It costs $699, £543, and comes in black, gray, white and green. Rubin believes the phone is an iPhone killer and can take on the likes of Apple and Google. Earlier this year it was reported Rubin had recruited over 40 people to his new firm, to be called Essential, according to Bloomberg. It aims to build an entire technology ecosystem using AI, from phones and smart home gadgets to app stores. A previous tweet shows an extremely small bezel, with Rubin saying he was excited to get it into more people's hands. A search in LinkedIn reveals several of the employees, including Niccolo De Masi, the ex-CEO of Glu Mobile, who is listed as the firm's president and COO. Rubin also recently hired Andy Fauch from Magic Leap, a Google-backed firm developing AI glasses. Bloomberg claims Essential will produce a range of both home and mobile products, and Rubin discussed his handset plans with Sprint executives at the recent CES show. Rubin registered Essential Products Incorporated with California regulators in November 2015, and in late 2016, the company registered Essential with the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office. There, it listed smartphones, tablets, accessories and computer operating software for mobile phones among its goods and services. Rubin is convinced AI is the next big change to ripple through the technology industry. New computing platforms happen every 10 to 12 years, he said at the Bloomberg Technology Conference in June. He believes that AI in the future will go one step further, being so powerful that it underpins every connected device. Mr. Rubin said a combination of quantum computing and AI advancements could yield a conscious intelligence that would control every internet-enabled gadget. If you have computing that is as powerful as this could be, you might only need one. It might not be something you carry around. It just has to be conscious. While Mr. Rubin's claims are currently theoretical, his investment fund, Playground Global, is investing $300 million in companies trying to make this future of AI a reality. One of the companies his fund is investing in is a quantum computing firm. Its name has not been disclosed. The company is made up of researchers who may one day be able to commercialize quantum devices using standard manufacturing processes, which could massively boost processing power. Mr. Rubin said, in order for AI to blossom and fulfill consumer needs, it has to be about data. That's where robotics come in. Robots are walking mobile sensors, who can sense their environment and interact and learn from those interactions. Foxconn is in talks to manufacture Rubin's new smartphone, according to people familiar with the matter. At least one prototype of Rubin's phone boasts a screen larger than the iPhone 7 Plus's 5.5 inches, but has a smaller overall footprint because of the lack of bezels, one of the people said.